This is the VOA Special English Technology Report. The Ford Motor Company built several versions of the Edsel from 1958 to 1960. Ford ended production of the car after just 3 model years because of weak sales. The Edsel has been described as a colossal failure. That is what the name has even come to mean in popular language. But the Edsel has also been described as a car ahead of its time. John Heitmann is a history professor at the University of Dayton in Ohio and vice president of the Society for Automotive Historians. He says, "It was a car that was controversial in styling. Its horseshoe-shaped grille is still remembered today." The Edsel is kind of the example of the car that never caught on. Professor Heitmann says the biggest problem was that the Edsel arrived around the same time as a recession. He says Americans were beginning to question their values. "It's a really curious kind of economic episode. It was actually quite severe, but also rather short. But it was at a time when many Americans were reacting to the dinosaur in the driveway. These very heavy chrome-laden Buicks and other cars, the 58 Buick, had 58 pounds of chrome on it." The Edsel was also a very heavy, very fuel-inefficient vehicle. Even so, some people say the Edsel's technology more than made up for what it lacked in looks and fuel efficiency. Shamrock Shelly Cleaver is the public relations director for the Edsel Owners Club in the United States. Mr. Cleaver has been a member of the club since it formed in 1969. He says the Edsel was the most modern car of its time. For example, he says it was the first Ford product to have self-adjusting brakes, but he liked one feature especially. The 58 Edsel had 5 buttons in the center of the steering wheel to shift the gears. That way, you could shift the gears with your left hand and keep your arm around your girlfriend or your wife, whatever, and keep on driving. Shamrock Shelly Cleaver made good use of that feature when he got married in 1958. He went on his honeymoon in an Edsel, with one arm on the wheel and the other around his new wife. The Edsel was named for Edsel Ford, the only child of company founder Henry Ford. Edsel was president of Ford Motor Company until he died in 1943. Today, the cars are considered collector's items. They can cost anywhere from hundreds of dollars to tens of thousands of dollars. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal.